According to the Centers for Disease Control, peripheral arterial disease, or PAD, affects about 6.5 million Americans over the age of 40. Memphis Vascular Center is sponsoring today's discussion on PAD, and to chat about its risk factors and some treatment options, we are joined by Dr. Scott Osborne. Thank you so much, Dr. Osborne. Sorry.
That's okay.
I know people do that to you. Okay, explain, what is PAD?
So PAD is a gradual chronic development of narrowing and blockages in our arteries, mostly in our legs, that over time affects the blood flow of the legs and can cause significant problems.
Wow. And what are the symptoms? You said, do people know that it's happening?
Mostly it's pretty silent, actually. Some of the first symptoms that people experience are cramping, leg pain, calf pain, thigh pain with walking that can gradually progress to the point where it's, you can't walk one or two blocks, can't climb a flight of stairs, that kind of thing.
Wow, and that numbness, that's another thing, cold and numb limbs.
Absolutely. So that's just a symptom of decreased blood flow to the legs. You get decreased temperature, and the nerves of the legs are very sensitive to the decreased blood flow too, and so that's why you get that numbness.
Wow. Okay, what happens if you don't address it? It's hard because, you really have to know these symptoms that you've shared with us, but what happens if you don't treat this?
Well, in the most severe forms of the disease, you get what's called critical limb ischemia, and you can get decreased blood flow to the point where there's not enough to keep the foot alive. Or if you get a wound, that the wound can't heal, there's not enough blood supply to support the healing. And then people are at risk for major amputations.
Wow, okay. Now, I'm sure that there are just a list of different treatments. Is this something where, like, exercise can help, or is it something that you have to address more invasively?
Well, it absolutely is. Exercise can help, and it depends on when the patients present in the disease progression. So in the most mild form of the disease, the first thing we're going to do is start patients on an exercise program. That's going to help improve the blood supply of the legs. And we've got to address those underlying risk factors they may have: smoking, obesity, diabetes, hypertension, cholesterol. All those things are big risk factors, that some of which we can modify and improve patients' prognosis.
So what's the next step when you realize that, it's still persisting, we need more help?
So the next step is to perform a minimally invasive office-based procedure called an arteriogram, and if we see those blockages and we can get little devices in there to open up the blood supply, like a balloon to open up the blood supply, or a stent to help prop open that blood vessel, and even in some circumstances use a device called an atherectomy device to shave off parts of that plaque to help the blood flow.
Plaque, yeah, that's a thing, and that's cholesterol, all that kind of stuff.
Right.
And so does it go beyond just the office visit, where you may need even further treatment?
Very rarely.
Okay.
Most patients do not need to, it depends on the form of the disease, the stage of the disease, obviously, but most patients don't need to be hospitalized. If we can get blood supply to the foot and support wound healing and improve their symptoms, they don't ever have to set foot in a hospital.
Wow, okay, and how long are you out of, so when you get this office procedure, do you have to kind of sit for a minute, or can you just go back to life?
Recovery is very short, generally just a couple days.
Oh my goodness.
And it's not like laid up in bed, it's just kind of taking it easy and recovering.
No ice cream and
Well, you can always have ice cream, but we don't prescribe it.
Okay, why'd I ask the doctor about ice cream? And that's supposed to be my little secret.
I'm a fan, so.
Well, one time I went to the dentist, and then I saw him in line getting coffee right after I went. So, now I feel moment.
You will see me in a coffee line, for sure.
Okay, no, but really, how can people get in touch with you?
Well, they can call our office. Our number is, I think, there, but it's 901-683-1890, and our address is there, and people can give us a call, and we can see people real quick.
All right, awesome. Well, I really appreciate you, Dr. Scott Osborne. Thank you for joining us, and thank you to Memphis Vascular Center for sponsoring our chat. Appreciate you.
Thank you.